Welcome to DC Digital Learning. Myself Suguna Hassan. Now I'm discussing session 34 of Organizational Behavior on the topic Advantages and Disadvantages of Working in Groups. So here there are a lot of advantages to the individual members to work in a group. Why an individual opt to work in a group? Why he chooses to be a group member? Why can't he individually go achieve his goals or individually he concentrates? Rather than doing individually, why the individual needs to join a group? So that there are a huge positive reasons to the individuals to join in a group for the togetherness, to belongingness, and to have the group achievements also. Here there are huge advantages which I have taken here. There are personal motives to join the groups. So even individual members also feel and they influence themselves to join the group, and there will be interpersonal attractions. So there will be other individuals also in the groups. As like others, we have to be in a group what the individual feels. And even not only personal motives, even organizational motives also motivates other individual members to join in a group. So that is organizational motives to join a group. Let us have one by one discussion. Here there are even other benefits also which we will discuss in the later. The first one is the personal motives to join the groups. Individuals without any force from the organization or without any force from others, they choose to join the group. Since joining the groups is voluntary and with their well wish or their likings, because of their various motives which affects the individuals to become the members or take the membership in that particular groups. That motives may be a free communication or open communication among the individuals, to share the information or to share their thoughts or feelings, opinions, suggestions like that. So whatever it may be the individual motives, so it urges, it motivates or influence the individuals to choose any group and join in that particular groups. So that is personal motives. Personal motive which happens voluntarily. There will be no force from anybody. Here the individual, his or herself, they're going to take the decision to join the group. This is personal motives. Second one, that is, it may be for interpersonal attractions. So here, why the individuals join the group? So that is another advantage, that is to have the interpersonal attractions. The factor that contribute to interpersonal attractions may be a common gender or similar attitudes or personalities or a same viewpoint or the like-minding or even the economic standards or the material status, whatever it may be. So their interpersonal factors which motivates them to go for the and it attracts them to go for the framing or joining to a group. So it may be like a similar caste, religion, or the greed, or whatever it may be, the same culture, or their perception level will going to match, and their personalities according to their personality matching. So they're going to frame their comfort level, that is called for having their belongingness together in the organization to solve their individual problems and the hurdles. So next point, that is organizational motives to join the groups. So here, so first point we have discussed, that is personal motives. So there will be action will be by individual, by himself itself, that is voluntarily it happens. But organizational motives which makes the individual to join, purposefully join to a particular group to accomplish that group task or the group assignment what they're going to assign from the higher authorities. So because in organization structure it defines based on the other various functional activities, the groups or the subgroups has to be formed. So for the accomplishment of those functional activities, tasks or the goals, it has to be like individual performances will not be possible. So that's why they're going to frame the individual groups or the subgroups. So this happens from the organization side, or the it defines in the organization structure itself. That's why organization also motivates to individuals to join to a group for the group performances. And next we're going to see that there will be interest in group activities. Some of them they will attract towards the different functions of the group, and there will be another point, that is need for affiliation, nothing but they need to be like bonding towards the further relationships or the continuity of the affiliation or the relationships for the longer period of time. That may be a reason. And support for the group goals, this is very important. And rather than their individual support, here the group support also to reaching the group performances is very much needed. We'll have the discussion of these three points now. So that is first one, interest in group activities. The group activities like sports activities or other functional activities or any events what the group going to organize, like a contemporary literature competitions or the functions, programs, all these activities, either it may be formal activities or informal activities. So it may be related to refreshment or entertainment or the enjoyable events or maybe a formal functions, whatever it may be. So these activities also motivates other individuals to join to that particular groups, that is interest groups, we can say it. So for example, most of the employees, they will be most interested in the sports activities. They want to be in a sports group. So like that. So based on their interest, based on their preferences, we can say it, priorities are the importance. They're going to frame the and they're going to join to the groups. Next point, that is support for the group goals. In order to work or in order to like contribute themselves for the achievement of the group targets, either it may be a formal target or informal target. So most of the groups which are framed for the social benefit also, for the serving of society also. So based on that interest, serving of people or society, based on that interest, some of the people join to these serving related groups also. And most of them, they will be like, they have to show their competences and they have to be like, their performances to be appraised by the organization. They are to be in a hierarchy or a priority. So these also, these individuals also prefer to join to the group. And these individual supports also, which is required for the group, for the achievement of the group task also. Okay, so individually we can't achieve the most of the risky targets or the risky goals or the objectives. So here it needs a support from other individual competitive skills also. So here, so this framing of a groups which helps for the those risky goals to be achieved in a right time and effective manner. So next one, that is need for affiliation, that is need of attachment, that is bonding or making relations with other individual peoples also, based on again their personal criteria or the personal interest. So and even retired and aged individuals also have the join. So we can say that most of the corporations or the organizations, they're going to frame their groups even after the their retirement also, for their regular meeting or for to talk or to solve their individual problems or some of the financial helping also after retirement, or when they are working also, they will be in the group. And even after retirement also, they're going to make their own cooperation, sahakara sangha, we can say it in Kannada. So every individual or cooperative societies also follow this framing of the groups after retirement of their employment also. So this is a need for affiliation, that is mainly attachment, because we are human beings, we are social animals, we need relations to be maintained properly, and it has to be most required for sharing our feelings, like whatever it may be, happy, sad, bad, whatever it may be. So we need an attached relationships. This is again one of the advantage what the individuals will get to joining a group in the organization. So these are the advantages we have discussed till now. Now we will going to have the even disadvantages of working in a group. So as we say, each coin has two faces. It will be one advantage and there will be another face, that is disadvantages also. Let us see what are those disadvantages. So these are the different points which I have covered here. So what are the even disadvantages or drawbacks or the demerits which we will get from working in a groups by the individuals. So let us see one by one. First one is unequal participation. This is one of the main drawback from the framing of the groups. Here the individuals with their motives, like a personal motives or the organizational motives, they're going to join to the group. And after joining, they will not participate in the performances of the group task or the assignments, whatever it may be. Others, most of the individuals, they even work or perform their activities in a harder sense. But most of them are the, some of them, they will not concentrate. So let us, group is doing, other members are doing, no, why can't I take, why should I take all this risk and all. So like that, they will escape from the participation. So they will easily escape, they will easily go behind that performances. This is possible in the group also. So second one is intrinsic conflicts. First one is unequal participation, that is every member in the group will not going to contribute their performances or competencies in an equal manner. Most of them they'll do harder, so no doubt in that, but some of them they will escape easily and they will go lagging behind that. So they are doing, why should I take risk like that? So it will be unequal participation. After that, there will be intrinsic conflicts. Conflict, nothing but a misunderstanding, a misconceptions among the individual members. There will be lot of communication barriers. Because why it happens means wide variety of people with their interests or with their different factors, they have joined together with these groups or the individual groups. So when they start work in a group, the disagreements, so it's sure to arise between the people in the group. So disagreements or misunderstanding what I said. So there will be a lot of, lot of communication barriers or gap between the communication. They will not with their personal thoughts and personal ideas, they will concentrate and they'll expectations of the individuals will be more with that personal thoughts and expectations. The group achievement or the group framing or the purpose of the group, they're going to forget here. So this leads to disagreements of their opinions, suggestions. So this again, which main drawback of the group means, which helps to other individuals to go with their conflicts and their not liking mind itself. This is one of the drawback. And third one is no individual thinking. So here, while working in a group, there is no place for individual or independent thinking. It is by no means no means of one man show. Here there is no individuality. So because it's not individual task or individual performance, it is a group performance. There will be a lot of members or the people who are involved. Every individual thoughts or the individual thinking or their ideas to be taken care here. They have to be opinion sharing will be there. So that has to be collaboratively and exactly to be maintained. Otherwise, so it will be like a one man monopoly, we can say that, one man show. So it should not happen. It is like a democratic way it has to be happen in the group activities. Otherwise, it leads to monopoly. So that's why So we can't say that, no, I'm not going to share my opinion, I can't give my suggestion like that. We have to be shared. But individual, so your suggestion or the opinion can be taken in the final resolution or not. But you must share your information, must share your ideas with the group itself. So after all the opinions and the ideas, they're going to have the final conclusion. That conclusion may be one individual's idea, but not all the individuals. So majority basis, they're going to take the decisions here. Next point, that is decision making takes the time. It is a time consuming process. Of course, because why it is time consuming means there will be more than two members, more than three members, they are involved in the group. Every individuals have their own interest, their own expectation that they have to share their information, knowledge, their ideas like that. So every by collecting of all those opinions or the suggestions, it has to be like a huge time consuming for the taking of a final decision and go with the actual performing of the performances. So prior to making any decision, all aspects are to be thoroughly discussed and considered. So what I said, so it has to be discussed properly and every individual's opinions has to be considered, have to give the priority. After all those, after convincing all those discussed matters or the considerations, we have to frame the final resolution or the final decision. So it takes huge of time and energy also. So this is the main drawback of even joining a group. So next one, easy to avoid work. So as I said before, no individual work, no individuality here. So no individual task will be recognized. So when it combinedly we are concentrating and even other members of the organization, most of them, they will start avoiding, they will start lagging behind, they will start going behind and escaping from their performances and their responsibilities or the duties, which we can say. So when a group is especially in a large one, it happens actually. So it is very easy for the person to avoid work and leave it to others to complete. So they're going to leave on the other members. They're working hard, they will do it. So why should I take too much of hard or too much of risk like that? So it will be in the minds of some of the individuals, not most of them. But so others, by seeing some of the individuals, even others also follow the same. This will become the drawback to group. So next one is a loss of creativity. So here, whenever we need to work as a group, group thinking becomes more relevant here. So because of this reason, creativity has to be stumped. It has to be like, there will be lesser chances for the creative thinking or the critical analysis to other individuals. Because every individual is different, unique. So they have to be, they have their own way of solving the problems. They have own style of thinking and coming to a decision. So here by creativity of all the individuals, it's not possible to consider in the group. So that's why. So some of them, they will not go for the creative thinking itself. So this is the main drawback of loss of creativity in working group. Next one, time consuming, as I before said. So for the decision making, for the achievement, all this decision making process and all these factors which influences achievement are the performances of the groups also. The group targets cannot be reached in time or in a right time. This is also has the main drawback on the achievement or the reaching of the targets or the group goals. In timely or right timely by the right person or the right group. So this is one of the most important drawback of working in a group. So this is about different advantages and disadvantages. So every concept, everything, it has its own positive ways and negative ways also. So by considering negative ways, we can't say it is not working properly because we have a lot of disadvantages. We will not frame the group. So we can't say like this. So by seeing advantage, what extras are, what we can extend with that advantages, we have to go with considering the most of the advantage rather than the disadvantages. So this is about advantages and disadvantages of working in a groups. So hope you all understood with this concept clearly. So I'll stop here. Next we'll discuss in the next session. Thank you, one and all.